So functional and non-functional requirement. So what is a software required document? So I was discussing about this software process activities. So software process activity basically consists of the four major steps. So requirement gathering, then design, then implementation and maintenance. So are the basic four steps. So with understanding these concepts, we have proceeded further to understand what is requirement engineering process. Here we need to briefly go through the functional and non-functional requirement. So the same vocabulary or the words repeats here. For example, the third requirement specification is the first step of the requirement engineering process. So what is the meaning of elicitation and analysis? What is the meaning of validation? And finally, what is requirement management? So everything here is all about the requirement. So specification, starting from specification till validation and management. So you have a requirement. So it goes through the certain engineering process. We have elicitation and analysis. Finally, validation is nothing but a testing of the requirement, whether my requirement is totally satisfied or not. So basically, requirement engineering deals with the services. Not only the services, it also defines about the constraints. That is, simple example, your requirement, you have a requirement that has to be developed as a software, as a customer. At the same time, for a developer, that the full requirement may not be satisfied. So he may scrutinize that particular requirement. So definitely the requirements are accepted only based on the constraints. There are certain conditions to be accepted at both end in order to satisfy the requirement. So you know what is requirement in brief? Requirement is nothing but it could be from both end. So requirement, say in certain scenario, it is a bid for a contract. So in simple words, for your situation, I would say, if I tell you to write a program, so with certain conditions, that is the requirement. So I say the input should be like this and output should be like this. So in that case, so how do you interpret, how do you write the program further proceed? So that is called as a requirement. So in this case, both the statements may be called requirement. So for example, so the basics for a bid for a contract. See, here is one of the scenario that has been given that is predefined. So here what is called requirement document of a system is being defined. See, there is some conversations. So after, see here, once a contract has been awarded, the contractor must write a system definition to the client where they are delivering it, so that the client will understand and can validate, can this requirement be satisfied? Can it, this requirement be converted into a software? So both of these documents, in the sense, the client, or sorry, the customer has given the requirement. That requirement has been discussed in front on with respect to the client. So I would say the client and the customer are the same. So the developers who want to develop this, again, they scrutinize, they do discuss the same requirement in front of them. So both of these documents may be called as a requirement document for the system. So this is just one scenario that is being given. So requirements could be divided based on the types of requirement. The few of the requirements may be user requirement, and few of the requirements may be the system requirement. User requirement, purely goal oriented with respect to the customer. So that is in purely natural language or in terms of a diagrams. So the same concepts you are going to study in module 2, that is in unified modeling language. So one more word is object oriented modeling language. Whereas a system requirement consists of a structured document, and it consists of a brief description, that is a detailed description. How does the system will work and how does it provide the services? Whereas in the case of user requirement, it is also in purely a natural language, in the sense in terms of a communication terms. Now we will elaborate what is user requirement in the case of insulin pump and what is the system requirement on the case of insulin pump. So let us see what is user requirement. In the case of the second case study, that is medical healthcare patient management system, it generates the monthly management reports showing the cost of the drugs prescribed by each clinic during that particular month. This is user requirement because user want to know the cost of the prescription that is pending on himself. So that is user requirement. That is at the customer level. Whereas in the case of system requirement, how does the system works with respect to this requirement? So if at the end of every month, a summary of drugs prescribed, their cost, and which clinic has been prescribed, that report will be generated. Again, with respect to the timing constraint, there is automatic generation of the reports at the particular time on the last working day of the month. Similarly, there are many system requirement specifications that could be written. That is, whether the drugs, the same types of drugs are available in different types of doses. So you could go through these system requirement and the user requirement. How does this user requirement and the system requirement are being connected with the various roles and responsibilities of a managers? User requirements totally rely on this client system, all these roles and responsibilities of a system. Whereas system requirement is purely dependable, that is with the effect of these roles and responsibilities of a system. For example, see, you can see software developer is no more involved with the user requirement. All of you could see here in the last, software developer, his main job is to write a program based on the given requirement. So he has been given a pure picture of what is to be developed or which program has to develop. He simply satisfied that particular requirement. He is no more concerned with the concepts of user requirement. Whereas if you could see system architects, his role is both involved in user requirement and system requirement. So now coming to the main concept, what is functional and non-functional requirement? What could be the functional and non-functional requirement? And one more is a domain requirement. So let us not discuss on domain requirement. So just try to understand what could be the functional and non-functional requirement. functional, as the name itself entails. It expects you how exactly the system should work. What should be the input and what should be the output. So as you could see here, functional requirement purely deals with the particular inputs and the how the system behave in particular situation. Exactly, if this is the input, this should be the output. This is my functional requirement. Then what should be the non-functional requirement? Non-functional requirement are the constraints. Try to understand. So this is one of the major thing that you are going to ask. Whenever you do a project, they ask you a very simple question. What all the functional requirement of your project and what are the non-functional requirement of your project? So in that case, how do you define a functional requirement? Functional requirement, basically, what does your system does? For example, if it is embedded system, you purely explain the functionality of that particular system being developed. If it is an image processing, you purely tell about the extraction, transformation, all those concepts of image processing. If it is a network concept, you might tell directly the number of packets that is being transferred from source to the destination. That might be the functional requirement. When it comes to the non-functional requirement, it is the constraints. So constraints could be anything. So you people have studied the words such as privacy, security. Or it could be the optimization. So all this comes under non-functional requirement. So one more constraints I would like to add, rigidity. So you could see non-functional, timing constraints, constraints on the development process, and few of the standards. So domain requirement, there is one more requirement. Domain requirement, basically, what is a domain? So if you work for one of the telecom industry, so your domain of work is a telecom. Same as if like there could be a few of the requirements that is being defined or the constraints on the system from the domain of operation. That is the limitation to that particular domain. Once again, this is a brief elaboration of functional requirement. What does the functional requirement do expect? All of you can give the attendance meanwhile, so we will review through the syllabus copy. So you could see here software process. So we have started requirement engineering process. In fact, this part comes in somewhere. So in fact, it is an important concept. So I'll discuss what is waterfall model, increment models. I came here directly. So requirement engineering process. And we discuss what is functional, non-functional requirement. Then there may be one more concept, software requirement document. How do you produce a software requirement document? So these are all the concepts we are going to study: requirement specification, validation, requirement management. Clear once again? So we have started requirement engineering process. So functional requirement also deals in the type of software expected by the user and where exactly the software is used. So in fact, overall it describes the functionality of our system services. So now coming to the one of the case study, MHC PMS. You know what is MHC PMS? Patient management system. That is mental health care patient management system. What should be functional requirement in this case study? So functional requirement. So you could see, as a user should be able to search appointment list for all clinics. The system should generate each day for a particular clinic list of patients who are expected to attend the appointment on that particular day. This is with respect to the patient. With respect to the staff, each staff members who uses this system, you shall be uniquely identified by his 8-digit employee number. This talks about the security, because some unauthorized person should not be able to access this particular system because it consists of a data. So that is we have a data of a patients that have a privacy to be protected. So these are all the requirement implementation. What is ambiguous data? For example, if I give you a confused input or the requirement to your program, until and unless you don't get a clear clarification of the program, you don't proceed further. So when you talk about the completeness and consistency of the requirement, always the requirement should be complete and consistent. You know, what is the same scenario I said, if I tell you to write a program without giving any certain clear clarification of the what does the program does, what is the basic input and what does this input do, so you will not get the clear clarification of the requirement. In the same way, the requirement should be always a complete and consistent. That is complete in the sense it should include brief description of all the facilities required. Consistency means there should not be any sort of conflicts or contradictions. So finally, the conclusion in practice, it is a highly impossible task to produce a complete and consistent data. But to an extent, we should see that to have a correct optimized output or optimize the system which can have a high consistency, that should include a complete and consistent requirement. See, once again, non-functional requirement focuses on few of the terminologies such as what is reliability, the constraints with respect to time, constraint with respect to data, constraint with respect to the input-output device capability. So, simple example I would like to reveal in the case of non-functional requirement. So, if the two programs are programmers are writing a same kind of program, that is, it takes the same inputs and it gives the same output. One programmer write the same program in 100 lines. Another programmer write the same program in 200 lines. In that case, so as a student, maybe you prefer the program with 100 lines. But in real scenario, you need to execute that particular program and you need to validate with respect to many non-functional requirement. So those non-functional reform time may be one of the maybe response time. How much fast that particular program execute and gives the output? That is the first thing. So how much reliable that particular program, both programs are? And also with respect to the storage capacity, so what is the memory capacity that it takes, whether the 100 lines or 200 lines? But maybe 200 lines takes more memory compared to the 100 lines. But in the same way, when you talk about response time, maybe it is fast. Again, some sort of contradiction happens. But for us, response time is a major thing rather than the memory. So that time, maybe I may prefer a program with 200 lines. So in that, in the sense of explaining these requirements, so you could analyze this scenario or the example where how do you analyze all this non-functional requirement. So you could see always non-functional requirement are major critical than a functional requirement. If at all, if these non-functional requirement are not met, so the maybe system becomes totally useless, in the sense there is no, see, if your program doesn't use optimization or performance, there is no meaning in saying that it is a program. So this is one of the diagrammatical representation for a non-functional requirement. Hope all of you have given the attendance. So this is one of the hierarchical flow. What could be the types of non-functional requirement you need to go through? Those who are not given in the chat, they can give the attendance as present. So see, today we just started what is requirement engineering. We have gone through what is requirement engineering processes. So now you could see what is elicitation and analysis. We have differentiated between functional and non-functional requirement. So we need to go through what is software requirement document. So before that, so the hierarchical flow of the non-functional requirement has been given shown. So let me stop today as of now. So tomorrow we would continue. Sorry, next class we'll continue.